Hi, we're the campus ministry team. I'm Cyrus.
I'm Nicole.
And I'm Steve.
Welcome to The Gathering.
We're glad you're here.
Guys, is this on? Can you hear me? Hey guys, welcome to The Gathering. We're glad that you're here. I know that it might feel like there's not enough seats for everyone, but I promise you there are. If you guys keep making your way around, we have a whole row over here that we'll use. We have this section here. And actually, we've got plenty of seats down here. So for these first few minutes, please make your way down and find a seat. If you're sitting on the edge of an aisle, will you guys just scoot in and make room for those who are coming in that they can grab a seat quickly? I see a lot of seats right here that we can use. So thank you very much. We are the campus ministry team. My name's Cyrus.
I'm Nicole.
It might be on. No, it's on.
Can you hear me? I'm Nicole.
And my name is Steve.
And we are super excited for this year. I'm going to let my wife take over.
Yeah, so we just wanted to take a minute to personally say welcome. So to upperclassmen, welcome back. We have missed you and have so enjoyed getting to connect with many of you over the past few days, and we're just glad you're back. And to freshmen and new students, transfers, welcome to Lipscomb. We are glad you're here and so thankful to have you as a part of the Lipscomb family. And even though you're only on day four of being an official student, you are an integral part of our community here at Lipscomb. So welcome. And we just want to take a minute. If you are new to Lipscomb, so that's if you're a freshman, a transfer student, or a new faculty or staff member, we want to ask you to just stand up. Yeah, give them a round of applause. Stay standing. Okay, so we're now, in just a moment, we're going to ask those of you who are seated, look around real quick, find a couple people who are standing, and in just a moment, when the music plays, we're going to ask you to just go to someone who's standing, go to a new student, staff, or faculty member, and just introduce yourself and say welcome, give them a hug or a high five, tell them you're glad they're here.
Hey, glad you're here.
Sorry about that.
Like we were something more. And it felt like maybe we could last forever. Forever. But you let them to our force the way inside. Now they want us to surrender. Us to surrender. But I could go all night right here between their crossfire to send them up a message. Okay, thank you. Have a seat. Now you have met somebody that you didn't know. You have a new friend. So next time you see him on campus, reintroduce yourself. And so, because this experience is really a lot about relationships. And really, the gathering is, I know it's not the place where you build relationships, but it's a place that hopefully that you will be encouraged in your relationship, you know, with God and your relationship with each other. And so we're going to read a passage. Really, it kind of sums up what we're trying to do as far as the gathering and also breakout chapels that begin next Thursday. And if you would, just stand up. This is from Psalms 25, and we're going to read it together. It's going to be on the screens, if you look at the screens. Again, let's read this together. Make me to know your ways, O Lord. Teach me your paths, and lead me in your truth, and teach me. For you are the God of my salvation, for you wait all day long. Good and upright is the Lord. Therefore, he instructs sinners in the way. He leads the humble in what is right and teaches the humble his way. All the paths of the Lord are steadfast love and faithfulness for those who keep his covenant and his testimonies. That is our prayer, and that is our hope. Would you remain standing as we worship?
In Christ alone my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest trial and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still and striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe. This gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was vain. Here in the death of Christ I live. There in the ground his body lay, light of the world by darkness slain. Then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, since curse has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death, this is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand. Come thou fount of every blessing, to my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. And teach me some melodious sonnet, sung by flaming tongues above. Praise the mount I'm fixed upon, in the mount of thy redeeming love. Here I raise my Ebenezer, hither by thy help I've come. And I hope by thy good pleasure safely to arrive at home. Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger interposed his precious blood. Oh, to grace how great a debtor daily I'm constrained to be. Let thy goodness like a fetter bind my wandering heart to thee. Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it. Prone to leave the God I love. my heart, Lord, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above.
Amen. Be seated.
Y'all, it's so good to have you guys back. Today is actually going to be a unique day in the gathering. One, we want to talk about why we gather, what it is that we're doing here once a week, and then another time in breakouts. Really, our rhythms as a faith-based institution, as we're looking to Jesus, we don't just want to know what Jesus said. We want to understand and do what Jesus did. And if you read through the Gospels, I was actually spent a lot of time reading through the Gospel of Luke this summer, and the amount of times that Jesus said he escaped or he went away and he rested and he took his disciples with him. There's this moment where no matter how chaotic the world around them was, Jesus was leading in rhythms of rest. And that is our hope for this place, that this place would be very restful. It would be a place of relationship that you get to spend 30 or so minutes with your friends, with other faculty and staff, with people that you've never met before, and use this as a time of real communion, both with each other and with God. And we're going to do our very best this year to make this a place that is led with vision and purpose, and we'll talk more about that in a little bit. But in order to do this space well, we have specific invitations for all of you. And we'll watch a quick expectations video, but this is an expectations not just for you all, but really for one of the ways that you guys can look to us, like, are we starting on time? Are we putting our best effort in making this space about family, about belonging, about you, but also about Lipscomb as a whole? And those are things that we want you to hold us accountable to. But I had some friends help me last minute put together a fun video. I hope you enjoy it. I think some of the stars are down here in the front if you want to point them out afterwards and laugh with them. So let's show that real quick.
Hey everyone, I'm Sean.
And I'm Danny.
And we're here to tell you about Chapel. We just want to give you the rundown of what Chapel's going to look like and hopefully answer any questions you might have regarding Chapel.
First off, every Tuesday and Thursday from 10:55 to 11:55, there's time built into your calendar to attend Chapel.
That's right. And on Tuesdays, we come here to Allen Arena for The Gathering. It's a campus-wide worship event meant for students, faculty, and staff.
On Thursdays, we have breakout chapels. And those meet all over campus. Every Monday, you'll receive an email on these locations.
And throughout the week, there are going to be tons of other opportunities for chapel. You'll get notices about them in your Monday emails. Look for times and locations. All students are required to obtain 30 chapel credits, 5 of which can come from service. Service is any volunteer work completed during the semester that is not part of your university requirement. If you are working a part-time or full-time job that interferes with your participation in chapel, then you can come down to the chapel office and fill out an exemption form. Chapel office is located in the basement of Bennett. If you only have classes on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, or if your classes begin after 2:45 on Tuesday and Thursday, you're only required to obtain 15 chapel credits throughout the semester, all of which can come from service.
Chapel begins promptly at 10:55, and doors will close at 11, so don't be late. We have room for everyone to have a seat, so please be mindful to make space of those coming into the gathering. Our goal is to be present with one another while in chapel, whether in the gathering or at breakout chapels. That is why we ask that you put your phones, laptops, or books away at the beginning of chapel. While we are moving towards using apps to get chapel credit, when technology fails, as it sometimes will, you are expected to have your student ID on you at all times. And also, you are responsible for keeping track of your own chapel credits, although the chapel office will send you reminders if you are running low. If you believe that you are missing a chapel credit, email the chapel office to set up a time to discuss your missing credit.
While it may sound like we're asking a lot of you, we also want you to expect the very best from us. We promise to lead with purpose and vision every single gathering. And also, we want to honor your time because we know that your time is important to you. So that's why it's important that we start on time so we can also end on time. And lastly, and most importantly, our vision for The Gathering is to create a shared family moment where everyone feels like they belong. Doesn't matter where you're at in your journey, we invite you to be here with us.
Oh.
Yeah, you guys can clap for those guys. Thank you, boys, for your help. We'll talk a little bit more in detail about some of those questions we answered, but really, we also want you to realize this place is a place of fun, and we can joke around and be real people with real humor, or also with real troubles. Like, sometimes life hits us and it's hard, and we also will use this space to recognize that there are moments where we just need to feel together. So we want to have fun and we want to feel, but more than anything, we want to be present. And that's why, you know, we'll do this every week, but we're going to ask you guys to find a seat. And we want you guys to be here, because if you're not here with us, we can't really be a family. And as we get started, I want to invite you guys to actually, if you have a couple rows and you're on that side, slide into the middle, because we have a lot of people who are standing in the back, and if you're standing in the back, we invite you to come down and join us. That's just an expectation we'll have for you guys each week. So come on down if you're standing in the back, and if you're on the sides, just slide in real quick. We'll do a real quick introduction. While we do campus ministry together, we also have some friends who help us with chapel office, and this is our chapel team. So do you guys want to introduce yourselves?
Yeah, I'm Jonathan Williams. I'm the chapel requirement coordinator. So if you have any questions about chapel, how many credits you need, chapel exemption things, feel free to stop by my office. I'm in the campus ministry office, and I'd love to talk to you guys.
And my name is Jackson Smith, and I am the breakout chapel coordinator as well as the head resident of Sewell. So you can come find me in my office in Sewell. Thanks.
You can introduce yourself.
And I'm Nicole, and so I'm the women's minister.
And I'm Cyrus, and I'm the men's minister, but I also work with the Joshua Project.
And my name is Steve Davidson, and I'm the senior campus minister and associate dean. And y'all are together, right?
Like we do.
Do you have the same last name?
We go together. Yes. That's what they said when
you're married. Yes.
We're going to answer some frequently asked questions, but we're also going to invite you guys to ask your own questions. So if throughout our conversations there's a question that you know you have, we may answer it, but if we don't answer it, we have some friends who are going to select those. So one of the few times we'll invite you to do this. You can pull out your phone, you can get on social media while you're here.
Only time.
But tweet any questions with hashtag Lipscomb Chapel, and our friends in ETS will help those go live with us after we get through a few of our own. So, Steve?
Okay. Tweet your, okay. How many chapel credits do I need to get? And Jonathan, I think that would be a great question for you to answer.
Yeah, that's a frequently asked question for sure. Yeah. So if you are a full-time student, you're required to get 30 chapel credits per semester. If you do not have classes on Tuesday or Thursday before 2:45, then you're only required to get 15 credits. Let me say that again, just so we're all clear. If you do not have any classes on Tuesday and Thursday before 2:45, you only have to get 15 chapel credits. And of those 15, all of them can come from service credit, or all of them can come from attending on-campus chapel assemblies, such as this, or breakout chapels on Thursdays.
Okay, good. All right, what counts as service, and how do I submit service credits? Nicole, you want to do that one?
Yeah, so you can receive service credit to contribute to your chapel credits for any volunteer work that you do that is not fulfilling another university requirement. So any service work that you do that you're not getting credit for a class or an internship or hours for nursing or anything like that. So, and you can submit those online through your My Lipscomb page.
Very good. Thank you, Nicole. Okay, where can I find more information about breakout chapels? And of course, since Jackson, you're the dude, so tell us.
If you're looking for some information about breakout chapels, the best place to go is the email. So we send an email out every Monday that has all of the locations. So don't delete that email, because you might get to Thursday and then realize that you don't have it. And so hang on to those emails. That's where you can see them. We try to keep those as consistent as possible, but we're always bringing in new breakout chapels, and occasionally locations will change. And so if you ever have questions about it, first check your email. If you don't have the email or you can't find it, then come to the campus ministry office to ask questions.
And this goes to everybody, not just residents of Sewell, right?
Yes, all people get the chapel email.
Everybody.
The Sewell residents get better emails because I put gifts in mine,
but
the chapel emails are okay too.
Okay, nice. Okay, very good. All right, what do I do if I forget my ID or I can't get scanned? Okay. Cyrus, you got to tackle this.
Don't give me this one.
You do it.
So if you haven't gotten scanned for whatever reason, or if you forget your card, you need to come and see us. We actually will have, after the gathering every week, there'll be a table. So if you don't have your ID, if you don't have your phone, because we actually will be talking about Teal Pass in a minute, we'll have a table every day in the gathering in the forum out there on the other side of the Hall of Fame room that you can come and talk to someone right after the gathering if you don't have your card. And if for some reason, well, really, that's the only option. If you don't have your ID or you forgot to get scanned, you have to come to us and send us an email or make an appointment, and we'll help take care of that.
Great. And I just got this text, like, what is happening today that's going to be really fun at 5 o'clock? Oh, there's a women's soccer. Yeah, 5 o'clock today. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Sorry. Okay, next question.
Was that a student who texted you?
Yes. Okay, they were on the soccer team. Okay. What if my schedule doesn't allow me to come to chapel? Hey, Jonathan, you got that.
Yeah. So we realize that many of you have a lot of responsibilities that you're trying to juggle. So if you have you're a full-time student, if you have a full-time job also, or maybe you're a full-time student with a part-time job or two part-time jobs, or you're involved in a Lipscomb internship for class credit, we want to work with you. So stop by the office, come talk to me. I'll have you fill out some paperwork, and we'll see about your chapel credits.
Okay.
And if you guys don't know where our offices are, come catch us after the gathering on your way out. We'd love to meet you.
Okay, I got another text from Luke Shoulders. He just said I lied on stage, so I apologize for lying. But Luke, where are you? I'm going to come get you after chapel. Okay, what if I don't get all my credits? You know, okay, I'm going to talk. I'll talk about this because I'm 6'6", 230 pounds, and you have to deal with me. We take this really seriously. I mean, yes, we're having fun up here, but chapel is it's a class. It's a pass-fail class. And if you don't get all your credits, you will go on probation. And if you go on probation, it really messes things up. You lose scholarship. You can't participate in clubs. Possibility of athletic scholarship being, you know, taken away. And so you got to get your credits. And you think, oh man, why'd I have to do this? And this is a part of our DNA. It is a requirement at Lipscomb. And we believe it's a good thing because we want y'all to come together, and we just want to challenge you in different ways. You're going to hear some awesome speakers. Some awesome things are going to happen in here. And so we want you to be a part of that. So, you know, make sure you get the credits that are required. Okay, we don't want anybody to go on probation. And if that happens, you'll be getting some information from me. So that's
and
that.
I'll add to that real quick. If there's something going on and you're having a hard time, and for whatever reason life has gotten really crazy and you're just finding yourself in a tough spot and you don't know that you're going to be able to get all your credits, please come talk to us sooner rather than later. Because we want to know what's going on in your life. We care about you as a person. And so we want to talk to you about that and work with you. And we are more than willing to do that. But it makes it really difficult when we don't hear from you until after you've gotten the probation email. So if you're having issues halfway through the semester, please come see us, and we want to talk to you. But there's only so much we can do at the end of the semester when it's over and there's no more opportunities to work with you on getting your credits, okay? But we do care about you guys, and we don't want anyone to go on probation. That is not our heart at all.
Nobody go on probation. And so thank you, Nicole. I mean, yes, please come see us. Please come see us and try to do it the week of or within the, you know, come soon and not at the end of the semester, okay? All right.
Can you read that, Steve?
Okay, if possible, how...
Watch out, the end of the stage is right in front of you.
Okay, how as a student can I get involved with helping in chapel ministry, the gathering, and or other breakout sessions? That's a really good question. And, you know, Cyrus, answer that. I mean, I know the simple answer is just come see us, but tell them. Tell them what they can do.
Yeah, we have lots of internship opportunities, whether it's volunteer or paid internships that we'll probably, we talk through mostly in the end of the spring semester. But there's always space to get involved. If you want to help volunteer at the gathering or help be an usher or scan at a chapel event, we would love to get you plugged in. That would just require you to come to us or send us an email at campusministry@lipscomb.edu or chapeloffice@lipscomb.edu. Either one of those, we'll be able to connect with you over coffee, or you can find our office in the basement of Bennett Campus Center.
Excellent. And this comes from Sam Smith. He says, is Levi Lusco speaking in chapel this year? And the answer is yes. And he will be awesome. So he'll be speaking in
and
chapel.
If you guys haven't read, he wrote a book called Swipe Right about relationships and intimacy.
Yes.
It's phenomenal. I've had guys and girls alike read it. He'll be here in about 3 weeks. If you guys need to get your hands on a copy of that and you can't, come see me. I've got a couple. But that's a phenomenal book about relationships, intimacy, and marriage. And he'll be here. I think it's both very relevant to guys and girls. He speaks from the perspective of a man, but he has four daughters. And so, I mean, he has a very balanced perspective about relationships and intimacy.
It would be great. Okay, where will there be chapels on other days besides Tuesdays and Thursdays? And the answer is, Jonathan, you want to do that? Jackson, you do.
Yes, there will be some of those opportunities. I'm looking to the right to make sure that that's correct. It is. There will be some other opportunities. Sometimes we have some on Wednesday afternoons at a time that doesn't go at the same time as most of our chapels. If you have something that always comes up on those days. But we will have other opportunities. We love to take time to break into smaller groups. And I think Jesus did that a lot. He met with thousands and thousands of people, but he also met with 10 or 15 people, and so we're going to have some opportunities other than those days if you have a lot going on, so you can get those credits.
Those will be in your chapel email as well. So again, that chapel email that you're getting every Monday is going to be really important, and that's going to have every opportunity available for that week to get credit, including external opportunities outside of Tuesday and Thursday chapels.
Very good, very good. Is Jackson single? Well,
yes, but I also work here, so I will not be dating any of you
off limits.
Oh, okay.
If you're a senior
next
yes.
year,
stop. Do not like this.
Okay, how many chapel credits is one chapel worth? Okay, today it's one. Okay. Tuesday was one, but this next Tuesday is convocation. Two chapel credits, two.
Bagpipes.
Two credits.
Okay. There will be rare occasions where there'll be a weekend event with Kyle Dickerson in the SAC. That'll be like a 5-hour event. You'll be able to get more than one chapel credit for an event like that. There will also be, I think, one chapel opportunity every semester. So this semester it's convocation. Next semester will be during Easter. There's also one Tuesday, Thursday that's always worth two because that balances it out. If you go every Tuesday, Thursday, you'll have no problems getting chapel credit. So there'll always be one worth two.
In other words, there's no reason for you to not get enough credits. There's no reason for you to go on probation. Please. Okay. All right. Next question. All right. Can we go back to facing the front of that one? Really? Y'all don't like this? Okay. Okay. Hey. Who comes to Impact? Okay. We face this direction. Y'all like it that way. So, yeah. And the problem is the bathrooms are broken over on that side. And so we decided, hey, let's just set up this way.
No, let's.
Or,
I'll give
really,
you a little bit of a serious answer.
Really? Okay.
Really? We want to create a space where we are together.
Yeah.
And there were some challenges with the way that it was set up on the north. And if we do this well, there'd be no reason for us to go any orientation at all. But the reality is we want everyone in a seat. We want everyone to be together. We have a ton of empty seats still. And the appropriate feeling when we invite you guys into our home, we want you guys to have a seat. We want you to be here and belong. And we know that logistically it seems like it's a challenge, but there's other things that we're going to do that we hope alleviate the stress of you having to walk an extra 50 to 100 yards. I'm so sorry. But the reality is it bottlenecks, but you can walk all the way around to get to this side. And we are doing Teal Pass, and we'll talk about that in a minute, to where if you download Teal Pass on your phone, all you have to do is click a button at the end of chapel and you'll get chapel credit and you don't have to wait any lines and you can exit whichever way you want. So there's a lot of other things that are coming that will make this not as stressful as you think it is.
Exactly.
But we are really intentional about being together, and that's why we've changed the orientation. And it may not stay like this forever, but that's what it is now for the near future.
Very good. Bad question, but good. Thank you. where can I check my chapel credits?
I can say that one. So if you go to My Lipscomb, I would hope that you've been on there at one point so far, freshmen and transfers. But if you go to My Lipscomb, student homepage, and there's a section that says quotas where you can check your meal plan, and you can also check your chapel credits. And so you can do that at any time. The big thing is, guys, just check that consistently. The most frustrating thing on our side of things is when someone comes in November and says, yeah, I was at chapel on August like 30th, but there's no credits. Like, why did you not come to us a couple of days after that? So we do that consistently. We know that the technology we use is not foolproof. It is not perfect, and so the mistakes happen. But if you come to us when those mistakes happen, a day after, we're a lot more gracious and a lot more lenient, because we can be than we can be if you come much further.
Also, for those of you that start using Teal Pass, you will be able to track your credits on your phone. So as you check in on the app, you'll be able to tell immediately if it went through. And as you look at your app, it'll tell you how many credits you had for the semester. So that's helpful as well. So it'll just be right there.
Very good. Next question. What's your favorite breakout chapel?
Men's chapel.
Yeah. I'm partial to women's chapel.
Men's chapel, women's chapel.
I've always enjoyed worship chapel.
Okay.
But I also really love visiting Mask Chapel. I'm responsible to be at Women's Chapel most of the time, and that is a really special place to me. But I have gotten to visit Mask Chapel, particularly when some of our students are sharing and speaking there, and love it a lot.
Yeah. Hymns Chapel.
Hymns Chapel. We got a lot of good ones. This one is way louder than that one.
It's a lot of good ones.
Here's the thing I want to say about breakout chapels. I really enjoyed spending time in breakout chapels as a student. What I want to encourage you is find somewhere that you love. Get a little bit out of your comfort zone, but find somewhere and just be consistent in that. That's what I found was the most powerful about breakout chapels, was the opportunity to consistently be somewhere, to consistently be with the same group of people, to dive into different topics. And we want to really have opportunities for us to talk about tough topics this year in our breakouts. And so if you have a passion for something, if you want to see a breakout chapel happen, come find me either in Sewell or in campus ministry, and I would love to talk to you more about that. But I think breakouts have a really, really cool opportunity this year.
Okay. All right. Can we submit requests for chapel guest speakers? Absolutely. Yeah, please. As a matter of fact, in the last 4 or 5 years, that's what has happened. We've asked people that you have recommended to us. So please do that. Please. Okay.
Probably any time for one more?
Maybe one more. Okay. Okay. She said, done with good questions, only bad jokes left. Oh, okay. Well, let me just say something about...
We'll read all the jokes later. Thank you.
Yeah,
I'll
do those later. Let me just talk about scanning, and we're going to talk about tilt pass in just a second. And only you can scan for yourself. Okay, you know, we've had people come and say, "My friend's in the bathroom and they're stuck," or something like that. You know, that doesn't work. Okay, you have to use your own ID, or the best way to do it, of course, is the Teal Pass, which Cyrus is going to explain in just a minute. It's much, much more faster, and it's what you want to do. Is it? What did I say?
Much, much more faster.
Yes, it is. Yes.
Quote us on that. Yes. It's much, much more faster.
So, but you know what I'm saying. Yeah. Teal Pass. Okay. But seriously, we have a zero, listen to this, zero tolerance as far as cheating. And the deal is, if you get caught cheating, you fail chapel. In other words, it's a pass-fail, it's a grade. It's a grade like any other class. And if you get caught cheating, you fail for the semester, you're on probation. So just don't do it. Do the right thing. Just do what we ask you to do, and everything will be okay. Okay? Everybody good with that? All right. What else? You want to talk about?
Yeah, I'll. So real quick, if you haven't yet downloaded Teal Pass, you can take your phone out now, and you can search in the App Store. You can search Teal Pass, or you can search Lipscomb Chapel, but you're looking for Lipscomb Chapel by Teal Pass. And as you download that, you can sign in with your Lipscomb ID, so whatever you use to sign into your My Lipscomb, that username and password is how you sign into Teal Pass. And at the end of every chapel, we'll hold up a slide, or whoever's leading your breakout chapel. These won't be in every breakout chapel, but they'll be in some, in our biggest areas of need. So like Collins or Shamblin, you'll be able to use Teal Pass there. And there'll be a slide that'll say you can now check in on Teal Pass. If you guys have any questions about that, or if you don't have a smartphone, there are still scanners located around the room. They're wearing chapel usher badges, and they'll have scanners, and they can scan your card. Here's what's important, guys. If technology fails us, if it's not working, because there are going to be days where it's not working, you are still responsible to have your student ID with you to get chapel credit. So keep your student ID with you wherever you go, because if you do not have your student ID, we cannot always help everyone. And I'm just going to say that. If you don't have it, that's on you. It's your responsibility to have your student ID with you. We'll do whatever we can when technology fails, but when technology fails, you need to scan your ID. So keep that with you at all times. If you don't have an ID and you're in here, and for whatever reason, we know that it happens sometimes, you have to come see us immediately and talk to us here in the gathering at our table in the forum there. Guys, this has been awesome. We're not quite done, but I just want you to thank our chapel team, especially Jonathan and Jackson. They serve you guys a lot. We would love for you guys to thank our guest Blake Parker, who helped lead us in worship this morning.
And the praise team.
And our praise team, let's not
that
forget.
That led with
your
him.
Very own
student praise team.
Yes. And before we leave, we would all love to pray together. So I'm going to invite us all to stand. I'm going to give you a couple more instructions. There's going to be more shared family moments like this. But because it's early, it's a little after 11:30, and everyone's got at least 20 minutes, we've got donuts on the way out. Donuts and music, yeah. We know that today, where we're talking about expectations and rules and all of that, it's not necessarily the most fun, but we're glad that you guys get to know who we are, know that we want to know you. We're almost done. We're going to pray together. Know that we want to know you. But we also want to create spaces where you get to connect with one another. And so that's what this is about. It's about rest, it's about connecting with each other, and it's about connecting with God. And so as we close out today, we're all just going to say the Lord's Prayer together. Because when we got up here to say we don't want to just know what Jesus said. We want to understand why he did the things that he did. And the disciples came to Jesus and said, Lord, teach us to pray. And this is what he gave us. There's a couple great minds that say all of the Psalms and all of the prayers can be summed up in the Lord's Prayer. And in doing this often, I pray that these words really begin to sink deep into our hearts, where it's not something that we just say over and over as ritual routine, but something that becomes alive. So let's all pray together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. You all are dismissed. You are able to check in to Teal Pass. Oh, hey, if you can check hear in. Me, you guys have 3 minutes. Sorry, 1 minute to check into Teal Pass. So do that now.
Check in
one
right
minute
now.
To check into
we
Teal
love
Pass.
You.
Right now.